Definitely getting cooler here on the Gold Coast. Definitely getting cooler. Now, admittedly, I still wear shorts, so it's not that cold. So, looks like this guy doesn't train legs very often. He can't walk. He can't walk. When your favorite jam comes on at the gym. There's no point coming to the gym if you're going to cheat yourself out of your sets and reps, even down to the quality of the rep. If you're not going full extension with 99% of exercises, you're missing out on the ultimate results, just like business. Don't start your social media fan page if you're just going to do it half pie, if you're just going to do one post every day. Save yourself the time. As the great Arnold Schwarzenegger once said, life is all about sets and reps. Sets and reps, my friends. Sets and reps. I'm off to go and do some sets and reps at breakfast. Oh, that looked bad.
I was thinking about this last night, like what we could bring in. Might get some more plants, might turn into a jungle. Friday is content creation day. We did a little live yesterday to let everyone know. If you have any questions, come and join us. We're gonna be doing these regularly on a Friday, unless of course we're traveling or we've got events on, but we're gonna make it a regular thing, 10 a.m. I like doing it on a Friday because I don't book appointments in. I don't have any, you know, sales meetings. I don't have anything of appointment nature, so it doesn't lock me down. Yeah, what can happen is during the week we've got a lot of different appointments here and there, and you know, coaching clients and so forth to serve, and you know, running sessions and trying to fit in some content in between. Now of course it can be done, but it's for me, I like to be, because when I create our content, a lot of it is coming off the cuff. The more creative energy I have available to me, which means, you know, I'm not thinking that I've got to jump on another call at 11, then 12, then 1, and so forth. You know, it allows me just to be free of, cool, today is my day to be able to serve with great content. So looking forward to pumping out some of that. And that's what today's going to be all about. You're going to see the inside scoop behind the scenes of all of that stuff. So hope you enjoy it. So what it means is you can literally, you know, when there's half a dozen people in here, you could be jumping from computer to computer if you want. If you want to work over there today, you could. You just log in on the user.
Oh, so it's like
sort of like an intranet, but yeah, it's iNet. iNet. I know that's a internet. SkyNet is what it is. Boom! Let's put up a Terminator thing. Whatever it is.
Check, not a SkyNet first.
That is SkyNet. I'm very, very comfortable with that being SkyNet. So what we're doing is we're doing some B-roll here while Jake is standing there filming me. No one's going to hear this, but if you're a really good lip reader, you'll be able to catch what we're really doing here. You know, I mean, it's like Facebook down here. If I point to the camera, I'm just looking at my phone, really. There's nothing even on it. Okay, Daniel, I'm going to give you the cold, hard truth. If your event is in June, which, or the end of June, you've literally got 25 days as of recording this. What you need to do is you need to get on Facebook Live every single day and you need to talk the pants off this event. Why should someone take time out of their day to attend this event? You need to show value all the way up throughout the month. You just need to get on there. Ollie OJ Matthews says content creation. But I think I could talk a lot about content creation. Just need to look at this right here, right now. Right, so we've got a camera there. We've got a camera here going live. So we are creating content on multiple platforms. We're creating content right here that we're going to use for our daily all or nothing vlog. We're going to use this for pieces on YouTube. We're going to use the Facebook for the Facebook. We may even rip this Facebook video. So I might come in and grab it, rip it off Facebook. And we might put some, you know, something on the bottom, something on the top. We might take a sneak peek out of it. We'll probably use some of this footage that I'm looking at here, and we'll slice and dice and make it all cool. I remember how much I loved doing it. It's one of those things you can get into this process of creating content, creating content, creating content, and then you get busy, things pop up. But I haven't done a live literally in over a week. Oh, actually, no, I lied, I did one yesterday. But before then, even a week, because I've just been so busy with what's going on. And sometimes that's just got to be the reality, you know? Don't beat yourself up for not doing it. But today was awesome. Got to crunch out, yeah, 36 minutes. Felt like 10 minutes. That's why I just love being able to. And if you watch it, you know, you'll see when I answer questions, a lot of what I was doing, I could see how my mind was working. It's like there's about six different questions, but they all in essence tied in with each other. So it was pretty cool to form the own matrix in my own head, which again was great value for people because you can add context from one question to another, and that's how people can relate as well. Doing those off the cuff Q&A videos gives the opportunity to the viewer to be able to hear one thing just like five, six different times, different ways. So I can't wait to keep doing those. It's awesome. We have a better set though next time. We're in the process of trying to create a set, something cool, something funky, something where we can make it memorable. So that'll be cool. Looking forward to it. Doing, brother? First question I have for you is what was the offer that you put on the table? Did you just make it the upfront option, or did you give them a flexible payment option as well? That's one of the big things, you know, at an event, getting someone to make a big financial commitment in a lump sum format can definitely scare a lot of people off. So I would be following up and making sure that, you know, you're looking at, are the bases covered? Have you provided another opportunity for them to jump on board? You know, with Authority Academy, you know, we do use our payment plan options, which work very successfully. So that would be something that I would be doing. I'd be approaching that methodology as well, making sure that you're, you know, for people who just had that monetary objection, figuring out a way on how it could work for them. Of course, within your means, you know, you don't want to give someone a $20 a week payment plan to pay off for 5 years. You know, that's not what you're talking about. It's something that could make it more available for someone to do. So look into that. So this is where we get a little bit advanced in regards to the campaigns we're doing. I start off with, first of all, I mean, I've got different checklists and stuff that I use, but creating all the different audiences of where we want to put our ads first, you know, so you're not sitting in the device going, where are we going to put this ad? Where's that ad going to go type thing? So, you know, this ad is actually a 2% lookalike audience of another audience we have. So it's... What I mean is it's complicated and you should hire the Campbell Media Group to do all your advertising needs. Do 24-hour shift tonight. You don't need to wait. It's non-paid. Non-paid. This is the love aspect. Yay or nay? Thumbs up or down? Thumbs up or down? Oh, let's not do the trade-off of love. Good news. Literally just press play on the ads for the event. We've got our first couple of leads already come through instantly. The beauty of Facebook. You gotta love Facebook. Far out.
Week one.
Oh, yeah.
Down.
Well, two, but one.
Oh.
But it's done. We made it. So our joke will now work 48 hours straight over the weekend, and we'll get ahead of the curve. But it's been great. Good week. Feels good to have the accomplishment. Like, if I'm recapping, I remember we were sitting down at the coffee shop, maybe yesterday, the day before, looking at the time pressure with everything that we got going on. You know, actually, do I have a piece of paper somewhere? No, I don't, but it is official. We now have registered the Campbell Media Group, so we're officially an operating company, so. Boom. Get that thug thing, you know, that they do those ads with the. With the cigar, thug. Boom. And that's how we win Friday. Keep an eye out for next week. It's coming. We're coming hard. Oh, that sounded bad. Jesus Christ. We're coming hard. I did that at an event. I remember I was speaking at, it was our last Authority Academy event. Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah, where I said strap on because I'm, strap on, put the seatbelt. I was basically trying to say put your seatbelt on because we're going to drive really fast. But it was like strap on and I'm coming for you or something like that. I was like, Jesus. Listen to what I said. I was like, oh, that's fucking stupid. What? Get on the message?
Yeah.
Bro, that message ain't going nowhere. I'm not. I can't reply to that. Pick a number between 1 and 163 and I'll read the first piece I see. Pick a number. No one rush at this though. 13.
How many metaphors are in that book?
There's actually not too many. We should do a reversion, a revised version of the Bredafors. I will have a book called Bredaphorically Speaking one day. I think if we accumulate enough metaphors, we'll be able to jump into it and get it done.
Top dog, bite them all, yeah, I'm burning it up. DPGC, you should be turning it up. CPT, LBC, yeah, we hooking back up. And when they bang us in the club, baby, you got to get up. Cause homies, thug homies, yeah, they giving it up. Low life, yo life, boy, we living it up. Taking chances while we dancing in the party for show. Slip my girl a 44.